My sister has Crohn's disease, and growing up with Crohn's disease, she wasn't able to eat normally. Anytime she gets stressed, she experiences a flare-up, so then she can't go to class. I always came here thinking I wanted to go to med school. And during my classes at Missouri S&T, I learned how Crohn's disease is caused by an acidic pH in your small intestine. And several of the S&T professors have developed uses with bioactive glass in the medical field, including cancer. So I thought we could use their research to treat my sister's Crohn's disease.
One of my neighbors, whenever he parks his car, he kept moving back and forth until he hit both cars, the car in front of him and the car behind him. So I ended up fixing my bumper like 3 times and parked my car away from my home. We were doing some research work. We were trying to find a solution for collision problem. We developed a new panel that can dissipate high levels of energy. And I was discussing the idea with my advisor. We came up with a new idea. Why don't we produce the same panels but in a small scale so we can put it in the car bumpers?
In high school, I was in a class with some Syrian refugees, and it just got me started thinking, it's unfair for us to live in like the big houses and for them to live in the tents. Can I do something to help them to improve their lives? They were living in those canvas and bamboo tents and might collapse any day. And then Eric and I, we got together and he was like, we could just build a shelter for the refugees. And we just started brainstorming together and we finally came up with this idea.
I've not ever thought of myself as an inventor. You know, as students, usually you're just trying to get through a class. You're just trying to learn what the professor wants you to learn. But as an inventor, you get to learn whatever you want and you get to apply that knowledge to anything in the world.
We received an email from the university that there is the EQ program. I didn't know that this program exists. And they asked if any student have a new idea for a product or a plan to start his own business.
Then we were challenged with finding a way to apply this research. So that's where we discovered the bioactive glass that we use. So bioactive glass, think of it not as window, think sugar. So it gets in the body and it interacts with the ions in the body and it dissolves.
First, the idea was just in our heads and we were like, we don't even know if the product can do this. And then as we like started learning more about it and talking to more experts, every time we brought up our idea, we're like, oh, this has never been done before.
Entrepreneur Quest is a program that allows students that are involved in startups to pitch to local small business professionals in a Shark Tank-like style in exchange for criticism and other inputs on their venture.
We were really nervous going into semifinals, I think, because one, it's at our own university, so all the people that are there, we know them. We've become friends.
You ready? We're presenting Bionic Bow. Our product proposes a bioactive borophosphate glass, so this will correct the abnormal pH as well as heal ulcers. 3 million people suffer from Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis.
The advantage we do have is in speaking with several attorneys, we are not a drug, we are a medical device, so that will speed up the process, hopefully shortening that timeline, allowing us to get it out there faster.
Here's an example of our product for you guys.
We're the ones setting the bar. After that first presentation, everyone knows your tips and tricks so they can try and one-up you in that time.
I practiced the presentation over 50 times. I have two feelings, like, shall I go very technical with the concept or try to make it as simple as possible? We are testing a piece of glass under impact loading with and without our prototype. So here's the glass broken, but when we install our prototype, it dissipates the energy. So it protects the structure behind it, which is the glass in this case.
My question is, don't you want to put that into your financials, additional research in the out years?
Yeah, for sure. This will be some
sure
cost we have to
put. I don't see it on the chart.
Yeah, okay. We have to add.
You're being very optimistic.
Most of the questions we received from the judges helped us to make our presentation better, modify our financial plans, and get new ideas to facilitate the selling of the product into the market.
26 million refugees exist in the world. Actually, only 10% of them are like homeless slash are living in low quality shelters.
What really separates you? There's a lot of selling points you mentioned, and they sound like features. What really differentiates you from your competitors?
So what really differentiates us from our competitors is the longevity of our shelters. They last for 10 years, which is So not a permanent shelter, but something that they need because the average amount of time they spend is 12 years.
Thank you.
Winning the S&T EQ was an emotional moment for us because we knew that the $15,000 could actually bring the project to life.
The initial thought is, yay, we can keep on competing, and then the next thought is, darn, now we gotta keep refining our pitch.
We were assigned a special mentor who went every step with us, and is our product is important and gonna solve a real problem in the real life.
Columbia was a completely different game. These people are the top 10 entrepreneurs in the entire state, and now it's time to show what we know, and at the end of the day, it's the judge's decision.
It was much harder than the first round in Missouri S&T. I go a little bit fast because I was nervous.
I was a lot more confident walking into Columbia's EQ than I was at S&T's EQ, because Yen and I both knew that the idea actually meant something to people.
Providing low-cost, safe housing for refugees, that's not where the money is, but that's where the need is.
Thank you.
And your concept, Crunch Barrier, think about incorporating that into a football dollar.
What I learned, especially from President Choi, is how supportive the UM system is of student entrepreneurship. They are really pushing us to continue to challenge ourselves and to go and compete in other competitions.
Since Columbia, we've participated in our first healthcare pitch competition, and we competed against all graduate and PhD students, and we ended up winning $10,000. So we're gonna use that money to start testing here at Missouri S&T and file a patent application.
The most important thing I learned is how to know your audience. What is the importance of your science and how to implement it in the real world?
If you would like to be an entrepreneur, start today. Because if you are always gonna tell yourself to start tomorrow and you're always gonna procrastinate, you are never going to do it.
Every person I know does things that I cannot imagine doing. People invent software, people invent stuff for video games, or even like a book cover that's super useful. And you can make businesses off of all of that.